Okay, so I'll begin by presenting myself. I'm Magda Budagerkarad, the longest name on your list, and I'm a professor at St. Joseph University of Beirut. Yes, I usually work on plant genetics, on conifers, and since I began my professional life at university, I'm also working on biodiversity conservation. Because I don't know if you know, Lebanon is a very, very small country, 100 times smaller than Ontario, for example. But it's a hotspot for biodiversity, and we have a lot of affinities with desertic plant, like in Syria, but more also Syria and Egypt, but also in Lebanon, you have a lot of northern, it's a northern limit for a lot of European species. So it's really very interesting as biodiversity for plants and animals. And there is a lot to do because a lot of our species are not discovered yet. For mushroom, for example, it's completely a black box. So yeah, these numbers are really ridiculous. I tried to find who is after these numbers, and a lot of your names are here. It's like a collateral discovery working on some museum samples where they were collected in Lebanon or present in Lebanon. So I will not spend a lot of time on this, but I can promise that these numbers will be much higher very, very soon. In fact, the project I'll be presenting here were not created for the sake of eyeball, but they contain components where we have species barcoding. For example, in this one, it's a project that we launched one year ago. Why we want to create a reference library for plants and animals. Our objective is not very high, but it was just for the sake of the project, but we are scanning wider. In fact, it was in the framework of a project for ecological restoration, because I co-founded NGO for reforestation, and while doing this reforestation and backing up scientifically this NGO, we wanted to know which species to plant, and for the ecosystem restoration, who are the animals or what are the animals that disperse the seed or can make predation on the plants, like herbivory. So we wanted to, we took a reference ecosystem, one nature reserve, and we are barcoding all the plant and animal insights. So these are some of our projects where we have already species barcoded, and we will be uploading them to the database very soon. We began working on this. We have so the basic infrastructure to do our molecular work, and we are using European facilities to for sequencing. The main problem, I will talk about it at the end, is a very high cost of chemicals. So, but we are doing it Phoenician way or Lebanese way, while doing some parasite on our colleague in France or Europe, where we will buy and ship them, hiding this in material in our luggage, so we can make some economy to do the work correctly. So these are some of my students and my team who are working in my lab. This is the second project. We will use a reference library we just talked about. And we will be doing some metabarcoding on scats, trying to understand who is eating what in our ecosystems, and to build the network in our ecosystem. Excuse me, I'm a bit in a rush. And this project, in fact, are funded not for the fundamental science, but we always try in our project to have some application. And here it's not very very difficult for Lebanon because we are considered somehow as a country under ongoing on development. I don't know how to, yes, developing country. But at the same time, we have human skills, but also infrastructure that make us use this infrastructure, this money very well. So we can apply for European Union funds, for American funds, for United Nations funds. So we are having a lot of proposition. All at what we need is people to write nice proposals and get this money and give good deliverables. Okay, so this is a project about this cat. And for example, with just this example, we have already a lot of these species that we found to find out what this kind of vulpes are eating all year long. And it helped us create corridors between nature reserve and what to plant in them in order to sustain this population all year long. I can make a list of a lot of projects. This is one of them, where we tried to barcode the oaks we have. We have more than 17 species of oaks in Lebanon. And you know, oaks hybridize a lot between them. So it's not a very nice example because there's a lot of optimization of the barcodes to use in this group. But we are doing quite well. So here I didn't put a lot of text, but I can just explain. Our strength is that we have, compared to the surface of Lebanon, a lot of species. I can say more than 10,000 if we add some fungi. The weakness is the expenses, but also that there's a lot of universities in Lebanon, 45 different universities in a very small country, and it makes a lot of people, not too much, too many of them works on biodiversity, but we have to make this connection and create this network for iBuild. The threats, there's a lot of other threats, but I put this one, slow publication rate, because what if we want to create incentives for scientists to join, all of them will think about publication. And one of the main threads there is that publication in our domain are not very, very fast. So we should work on this just to try to catch them and encourage them to join. The opportunities are a lot of opportunities. We are a Mediterranean country. We have a very nice connection with the Mediterranean countries, but also with the Eastern Mediterranean. For example, with Jordan, Syria, Iraq, and Iran. And I think we have a very good key role to play as to create this community. And for making, for example, workshop for barcoding, it will be very nice for the region, and we are able to do it technically, and we have the network for this. So this is something I'll be working on very soon. So yes, I think that's it. Thank you. Thank you very much.